Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero training course. In our last lesson, we showed you how to add bank and credit card accounts and download transactions into Xero. In this lesson, we're going to show you how to reconcile those downloaded bank and credit card transactions. So follow along with me, log into your Xero account now, or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. While you save a ton of time by setting up an automatic bank feed between your bank account and Xero, there are several steps that you must take once your transactions have been imported to ensure transactions that downloaded into Xero match up with what you have entered into Xero. So for example, transaction date, payee, and amount. All transactions have been downloaded into Xero and there are no missing transactions. And finally, all transactions are categorized to the appropriate account. This will ensure that your financial statements are accurate and always up to date. If you have set up bank and credit card accounts with either a direct feed or a Yodlee feed, then you will receive new bank and credit card transactions at least once a day. With this daily update, there is no need to wait until the end of the month to reconcile your bank and credit card accounts. Before you begin to reconcile a bank and credit card account, it is a good idea to make sure that you have entered several transactions for the time period you are reconciling. Invoices, bills, credit note cash refunds, and expense claims. Entering these transactions before you begin reconciling will save you time since you won't have to enter them as you are reconciling, which may slow you down. When new transactions have downloaded from your bank account, you will see a reconcile button that shows you the number of transactions as indicated here in this screen. You want to click on this button to see the details of the transactions that need to be reconciled. As soon as bank and credit card transactions are downloaded, Xero compares them to transactions that you have entered into Xero. As a result, transactions will generally fall into one of three groups: match, bank rules applied, or suggestion. Let's discuss each of these next. Starting with a match, Xero automatically matches transactions downloaded into Xero with the appropriate transaction, for example, invoice or bill, in your system. The matches are based on amount, closest due date, and then the customer or supplier contact name in this order. So let's take a look at an example. On the left here, this is the transaction that was downloaded from the bank. So it says review your bank statement lines. And then on the right, these are transactions that are already in Xero that Xero is trying to match up with. So notice how these two transactions, Xero has matched up based on the dollar amount. We've got also the date. And then also we've got the check number that appears here and here. So what we can do is to accept the match, you can go ahead and just click the OK button. And once you do this, Xero will mark this transaction as reconciled. And it'll disappear from the screen. If Xero finds more than one possible match, then it will match it to the most likely transaction and then provide a link to the other possible matches as indicated here. If you don't want to accept the match that Xero has made, you can simply click this link to other possible matches found and select the appropriate item that should be matched up with that transaction. Bank rules are a way to quickly reconcile transactions that you have not entered into Xero. This comes in handy, especially for those recurring transactions. For example, let's say that Bluehost bills you monthly for web hosting services. You can set up a rule that will always code Bluehost transactions to an expense account called web hosting fees. To learn more about how to set up bank rules, you can click the link below. So if a downloaded transaction meets the criteria of a bank rule, then Xero will apply that bank rule as it has done in this example here. So notice we have the notification here that says apply rule. And so we want to go ahead and accept the rule application. We can click OK. If you don't want the rule to be applied, you can click the OK button here to go ahead and accept the rule that was applied. or you can click the Don't Apply Rule link if you don't want the rule to be applied. If Xero cannot find a matching transaction or a bank rule to apply, then it will suggest that you create a transaction based on a previously reconciled transaction with similar details. So as indicated, that's what Xero has done here, where it has already populated the who, what, and why description based on this transaction or a similar transaction that was reconciled maybe in a previous month. So to accept this transaction, you can also click the OK button and Xero will go ahead and mark this transaction as reconciled. The majority of your bank and credit card transactions will most likely be reconciled using one of the three methods that we just discussed. However, if you still have a few unreconciled transactions, we've got a few more techniques that may help you. Let's start with the Find and Match tool. Then we'll talk about spend and receive money transactions. And finally, we'll wrap it all up with cash coding. You can search for a bill, invoice, or account transaction that was entered into Xero and reconcile it with a downloaded transaction from your bank. From the reconciliation window here, find the transaction that you need to locate a match for. So we'll do this one here. And to the right, we want to click this link that says Find and Match. In this next screen, we'll be shown a list of transactions that match to the downloaded banking transaction. So within this screen, you can scroll down to review the transactions to locate one that will match the transaction that was downloaded. And so as you can see, we've got a couple of transactions for this smart agency, which is the same information up here. This is going to be ideal if you've got more than one transaction in Xero that matches up with one line item from your bank statement. So to select the transactions, you want to just go ahead and put a check mark in the box for the transactions that you want to go ahead and match up. So notice that these two transactions total $4,500, which also totals the transaction that was downloaded from our bank. If you scroll down to this section, it's just showing you the transactions that were selected to confirm that those are the transactions you want to match up. So you want to go ahead and verify that that's correct. If you need to add a new transaction in this screen for some reason, you can actually do that by clicking this button here. When you enter a new transaction, you can enter a spend money or a transfer money transaction here. To learn more about spend money transactions, click here to check out our How to Manually Enter Bank and Credit Card Transactions lesson. So we are satisfied that these two items match up with that particular transaction. So we'll go ahead and click the Reconcile button here to accept that. For those transactions that you know you have not previously entered into Xero, you can add a spend or receive money transaction to record and reconcile a payment that is not related to an invoice, bill, expense claim, or a bank transfer. Remember, you only want to do this for transactions that you have not entered into Xero. So for example, this Cooper Street Bakery transaction here for $15.75. We know that is not in Xero, so we'll go ahead and create a spend money item here. So make sure you're on the Create tab, and then we'll go ahead and complete this information here. So go ahead and complete the Who field. From the drop down on the What, you want to select the correct account that this needs to be categorized to. And it's optional, but usually I like to put a description in the Why field here for the purchase. So once you complete those fields, you can go ahead and click OK to reconcile that item. The third technique is called cash coding. Cash coding shows all unreconciled bank and credit card transactions that have been downloaded into Xero in a spreadsheet format. So you will create a spend or receive money transaction that matches and reconciles with your downloaded banking transaction. So to do that, we'll go ahead and click on the cash coding tab here to the right of the reconcile button. Please note that cash coding can be a very powerful tool and should only be given to an experienced bookkeeper or accountant. To learn more about user permissions, our How to Invite Multiple Users in Xero lesson walks you through how to grant or restrict access in Xero. You can click here to access this lesson. All right, here is our cache coding window. So in this screen, we have our transactions, the same ones that were on the previous screen that still remain unreconciled. So we've got our columns here across the top, and you can actually sort most of these columns by just clicking on the column name to sort all the payees together, for example, which can be very helpful, as you'll see in a few minutes here. Let's talk about the rest of these fields. So we've got our payee field, which is who the payment was made to, or maybe who the payment was received from if it was a received item. In the reference field, that's typically optional, and it can be used to enter a reference number or any additional information that you would like to indicate here to identify the transaction. Again, description, this field is also optional. You can use it to enter additional information about the transaction. The account field is a required field, and you are going to select that from the drop down here to properly categorize the transaction. The tax rate field is also a required field, and so you will select the appropriate tax rate from the drop down here as well. One of the benefits of using the cache coding technique is that it allows you to code a batch of transactions all at once. So let's go ahead and take all of these central city parking expenses, and we'll go ahead and put a check mark here next to each of these. And so we'll go ahead and batch code all of these since they are the same payee. So to batch code all of these transactions, we only need to complete the fields for the very first transaction. So we'll go ahead and do that, and then you'll see how it works. So downtown parking fees, and then I'll press tab to move over. Notice how Xero copies downtown parking fees to the remainder of those transactions in the list. And then we'll go ahead and select the account here from the dropdown. Automobile expense, and I'm going to press tab. Once again, Xero has copied the account down to every field that I selected. And the tax rate, we'll go ahead and select here 0% and press tab. So what's nice about this is instead of coding each transaction separately, you can batch code transactions, as I mentioned. And then once you have completed all of the information that you'd like to indicate here, you can click the Save and Reconcile Selected button here. And all of those transactions have been saved and reconciled successfully here. Be sure to check out shortcuts on how to reconcile using cache coding. You can click the link below to access this information. After you have reconciled all transactions, you need to make sure that you are in balance. This means that all downloaded bank and credit card transactions match up with a transaction in Xero. You can do this in a couple of ways. First, take a look at the bank balance that appears on the dashboard. So on the dashboard here, we've got a statement balance, and you want to make sure that balance matches with what your bank statement says. If you are in balance, then good job. However, if you still have unreconciled items and you were under the impression that you had reconciled everything, then you need to review the reconciliation summary report. We will talk about both of these next. To run the bank reconciliation summary report, we're going to navigate to Reports, All Reports, scroll down to the Accounting section, and then you should see the bank reconciliation summary report. So we'll click on that. So in this screen, we want to go ahead and select the bank account and the date that we know we reconciled transactions through. And go ahead and click the blue update button to update that information. And so here This is where you're going to actually see the comparison of the balances in Xero to your bank statement balance here. So as you can see, they do match, which is always the goal here. If you scroll back up to the top, you'll notice this tab that says bank statement. And so we'll click on that. So here, what you're going to see is this is going to display each banking transaction that was entered manually or downloaded into Xero via the bank feed. In this screen, you can see the transaction date, the description, the date the information was imported into Xero, reference information, and if you scroll down, and there's a scroll bar to go over to the right, you also see a column that says reconciled, so that lets you know the transaction has been reconciled. Again, it means you have a transaction that's been matched up in Xero to the downloaded banking transaction. The source of the information, here we see imported, the amount, and then again, the running balance on the account after each transaction has been calculated. On this third tab here, next to bank statement, statement exceptions. This tab will show a list of transactions that were not reconciled along with the reason. So fortunately, we don't have any information here for this time period, but as you can see, based on the columns, it will show a reason here, the amount, and all the other details of any transactions that were exceptions. This is the report that you're going to want to focus on if you still have those unreconciled transactions on the dashboard, even though you thought you had reconciled everything. You want to come right to this report to see what transactions are causing the issue. If you are still out of balance after reviewing the bank reconciliation summary report, the bank statement, and the statement exceptions, go ahead and take a look at our troubleshooting tips on reconciling. You can click the link below to access this information. And that's going to wrap up the lesson on how to reconcile downloaded bank and credit card transactions, also known as bank feeds, in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.